Okay, take a look up here now because I need your attention. First of all, put this date somewhere because I think this is the date we're going to be taking the EOC. And it's real important, especially for any algebra class. So put a star by that and write it down. It gives us a little bit of time, but we only have 3 days a week to work. So that kind of cuts it down. All right, look up here. The greatest common factor. Well, first of all, some of you really didn't show me the work. You had an answer, and I gave you credit, and I probably should not have. This is 3 times 15, I think, and then 3 times 5. Okay, any questions about what I did? Got to show me work, okay, because I got to make sure you're doing it. All right, if you understood this, then you start looking what's in common. Well, I see a 3, so I take a 3 out. I see a 5, so I take a 5 out. I see an X, so I take an X out. Any questions about what I did so far? Did I miss anything? Does anybody see anything I missed? All right, what's 3 times 5x? 15x is the answer I want. Any questions about how I got 15x? Now, let me show you the difference between what we did yesterday and what you're going to do today on the bottom of that sheet. So look up here. You take 15x out and put parentheses. And then you start looking to see what's left. Is there anything left in this circle here? No, so put a 1. If you take everything out, you put a 1. And put a plus. Is there anything left in this parentheses?
Yes.
A 3x. This is your answer. That's called factoring. What's in common? Write that down. Factoring, what's in common? That's the first thing you always ask. Copy this down. All right, this is only going to build. This is the first step for factoring. All right, let's move to another one. Watch again. I know that there's a 9 inside of here because I know my times tables, okay? So this is 9. I'm just going to leave it as 9. This one is 9 times 3. Now you might say, well, wait a second. You didn't prime it out. That's true. I didn't prime it out because I knew they had a 9. Both of them had a 9. Okay? So I'm kind of like beating the chase here. So I'm circling my 9. So I'm going to take a 9 out. They don't have anything else in common. So I put my parentheses. This is factoring, okay? I took all the 9 out. There's nothing left, so put a 1. The only thing left here is 3x to the third power, and I'm done. And that's called factoring. Yes? We're doing factoring. That's what we're going to do today. Yesterday, I just had you do that. But today, we're doing a little more. All right? If that confuses you, we're going to do a couple more. All right, but hang tight. The last one I wanted you to multiply. How much is a squared times 2a? Does anybody know? You got to add your exponents. That's what that test was about. It's not going to be 3 because it's 1 times 2 is 2. 2a to the what? 2a to the third power. How much is a squared times 4? 4a squared. You got to kind of get these concepts in your head, okay? It's not 5. It's not 3, okay? You multiply the numbers, but you add the exponents. All right, is everybody clear on what I'm saying? All right, put away your bellware. I want you to find the GCF for that top one, and then we're going to factor it. Find the GCF for this one. Copy it down first.
paper over there by the pencil sharpener. And there's a hole punch as well. Now, I don't remember lately of any parents in here giving any supplies. It'd be nice to get some pencils. It'd be nice to get some eraser caps, because I give them out. I know I gave them out for this class, too. So if your mom has me, it'd be nice to get a set of pencils or something, so I can give them to kids who don't have them. Makes the day a little more pleasant. Okay, start breaking it down. Not on this. Right here, what you're doing is factoring. You're doing prime factorization. Just like you did on yesterday's worksheet. You got to break it down and then see what they have in common. 3 is already a prime number, so just bring the 3 down. If it's already prime, you can't break it down anymore. A composite number, yeah, you can break that down. That's why it's called a composite. It's a mixture. All right, look up here. Well, the 3 you can't break down, so bring the 3 down. Here, you can break that up as 2 times 4, but you can break that 4 down as 2 times 2. This is what you should have on your paper. Now, if you don't have this, you need to ask. Before I go any further, is there anybody who doesn't understand how to prime factor? I know your 8th grade teacher tried to teach you the concept of prime factorization. I hope so. But there it is. Now I got to see what they have in common. Well, it looks like they have a 3, but this one doesn't have a 3, so I can't take a 3. I can't take a 2 because they all don't have a 2. But the only thing I can take is a Y. So take a Y out. Is there anything else that anybody sees that I might have missed? All right, if you don't, then let's go on. What's left inside this circle? 3Y what? 3Y squared. And then put your sign, minus. What's left in this one?
2.
How much is 2, 2, and 2?
6.
It's not going to be 6. 2 times 2 is what?
8.
2 times 2 is what?
4.
And 4 times 2 is?
8.
It's going to be 8. 8y. Everybody with me so far? Well, this one only had 2 y's, and I took one of them out, right? If it has 2 of them and I took one out, there's only going to be 1 left. Okay. All right. Put your minus. What's left on this one?
9.
That's how you factor. That's called factoring. Okay, now it gets harder. This is the first stage. All right, try this one. I want you to factor this one. Copy it down first. Break it up second. Break it up. See what they have in common, called the greatest common factor. That says 3 into the 4th power. I don't see that.
Oh.
Bottom one was the one we just finished. I don't want to get the feeling you're doing something different than what we're doing.
All right, well, let's see. So we don't burn up too much time today. Well, I'm going to take that 3 out. Two times 3, and then 3 times 3. Any questions about what I did so far? Everybody clear on this? All right. Well, I'm going to circle a 3 because I see that. I also see an N, so I'm going to take an N out. Is there anything else that I missed? So I'm going to take out a 3N. What is this 3N called? Does anybody know?
3NQ.
What's it called? 3N. Anybody know? The greatest common factor. That's what you did yesterday for homework. But now we're going further. Okay. What's left in this circle here? Into the what? Into the third power. What's left in this one? 2N. And what's left in that last one? Now it's factored. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? All right. Now, also today, yes. Well, I don't know about the last one because I'm already past it, but I will tell you that this is right, and let me show you why. 3 times 3 is 9, and the N stays as part of the answer. 3 times 2 is 6, and N times N is N squared. And then watch the last one. 3 times 1, because there's a 1 right here. 3 times 1 is 1, 3 rather. And N to the first and N to the third is N to the fourth. So this is correct if you distribute it back in. All right. Now we're going to do something called FOIL. Copy down this one right here. This is a binomial times a binomial. So we just did factoring, so don't forget that. That's part of your work. But now I'm going to give you a little more. So you have to step it up a little bit. All right. Now watch how you do this. You might have seen this on your test. All right, here we go. You draw your arrows. Now I'm not going to go through the acronym right now. So take this X and draw an arrow here and draw an arrow here. And then take this 3 and draw an arrow here. And draw an arrow here. You should have 4 arrows. Is everybody with me so far? All right, here we go. How much is, now you got to think back on that test some of you didn't do too well on. All right, but look up here. How much is X times 2X? 2X what? 2X squared, because you got to add your exponents. That's what that test was about. When you multiply, you got to add your exponents. These are the rules. I didn't make these rules up, okay? What is X times negative 5? Negative 5 what? Negative 5X. Now I'm finished with the first one. Now let's do the second one. How much is 3 times 2X? 6X. Put a plus right there. You might say, well, where the heck you got a plus from? And that's a fair question. Because a positive times a positive is a positive. How much is 3 times that negative 5? Negative 15. Now write this down. CLT. Does anybody know what that might stand for? Combine like terms. Okay. These are like terms. Do I have more pluses or do I have more minuses? How many more pluses? So my final answer on the ELC is 2x squared plus x minus 15. If you want to put a 1 right here, go ahead. I'm not going to. I'll put a dotted line just to show you it's okay. Is everybody clear on what I did? All right. Now it's your turn. Try this one. Try that one. Draw your arrows and see how far you can get. Some of you catch on really quick.
I can show you one time, and you got it. Some of you need a little extra help. And if you know you're one of them that needs a little extra help, you should be paying real good attention. Now, I'm real happy that you guys went home and did your homework. Three of you did. You might say the dog ate it. Mom has it in her purse. Whatever. But you know you didn't do it because you don't have it. All right, I'll give you about 30 more seconds. That's about all I can give you. Buy like terms if you got some like terms. Remember what I told you. I'm not going to be able to teach you everything because they only give me 3 days a week. You got to rely on that program at home, and a lot of you didn't do your work. On that Carnegie. Yeah, I got it. It is hard. Maybe you were not taught it. I understand that. But they do give you examples. And some of you are just blowing right by the examples and then you're crying, oh, I can't do it. Well, because you didn't try. I bet you if you read the example, you might be able to do it. Takes a little more time. I understand that. All right, look here. Watch now. How much is 4x times 1x? 4x what?
Squared.
Good. How much is 4x times that negative 7? Negative 28x. So far, so good. All right, that's the first one. Let's move on. Let's go to the next one. How much is 3 times x?
3x.
And what's 3 times that 7? Any questions so far? Look at your work. See if you have that. Okay. If you don't, I mean, it's not a big deal, but you got to learn it eventually. We're going to combine like terms. How much is this one and that one?
Negative
25. Negative 25. I got more negatives, so it's a negative 25. Very good, Robert. This is the answer. Any questions about what I did? That's called FOIL. I didn't really teach you that. I just showed you with the arrows. Here's your assignment. You have about 20 minutes. We did not finish this worksheet. So you're going to factor these. First, you got to do the greatest common factor. Got to do that first, and then you got to see what's left. I'll do one in a minute. And then secondly, I'm going to give you this worksheet. It's got a million problems on it, but I'm not going to make you do a million problems, okay? You're only going to do like maybe 9 of them, just to give you something to do. That's what we just did with the arrows. Everybody clear? All right, let me pass this out. I want you to do the bottom right now, and then the first 9 of these will be done. All right, I'm going to do 1 or 2 of these to make sure we understand each other, okay, what I expect. All right, well, you were taught how to prime factor. So put 2 times 4, and then 2 times 2, and then x. Don't circle that 4. I don't have a lot of room there, so I had to squeeze that in. 4 is not a prime number. All right. This one is 2 times 5. Now you got to ask, what do they have in common? Hence the word greatest common factor. Circle the 2. That's the only thing they have in common is a 2. So take a 2 out. Now you got to write what's left. Well, 2 times 2 is 4, so that's 4x. And then the sign right here is a plus. So put a plus 5. You can check it. Watch how I check it. 2 times 4x, bam, 8x. 2 times 5, bam, 10. I know this is right because I know how to check it. I don't have to write it out. I can just see it in my head. Now try another one, and if you get stuck, ask, okay? That's why I'm here.
Get it?
Yeah, but I think I took the old one. So it's this one.
Yes,
right?
No.
That's the old one.
Okay, good.
I noticed that they swapped geometry, which I'm glad. I wish you would have done it earlier. Because we kept telling her, like, Algebra 2, we still have many, many chapters to teach.
Oh, I know.
Geometry,
please.
We're
I'm
close to done.
These guys.
I know.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. I'll bring it right back.
No, it's yours.
Oh, you don't need it?
I'll just print another one.
No, I'll make it.
No, no. Keep it. Somebody's on the machine anyway.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
For average 29, I'm kind of confused. If we're doing it in order, I think it would be 2 times 3 is 4.
Okay, let's look at 29. You ready? Well, on number 29, I can see they have a 6. Actually, they don't have a 6. They have a 4, but here we go. 2 times 6 and 2 times 3 and then n. Is that what you have so far?
Yep.
Yes.
You sure?
Yeah.
I mean, if not, write it down.
No,
but
I
This one is 2 times 4 and then 2 times 2. Now you have to see what they have in common. They have 2 2's. Well, 2 times 2 is 4. I did it. Usually I don't, but I did it. Yeah. And then what's left is 3n squared minus 2. Does that make sense? Isn't that amazing? Not everything is totally confusing, but yeah, it does kind of make sense. Who else needs help?